Good evening, Grayson. This is Steven. Hey, it's great to work with your machine here. We've had a great time with it, and we're continuing to help you, help it evolve. I think one of the coolest things we've done just immediately is now we've gotten, since I stuck myself with it, we've gotten this to be better. It's still a little bit loose back here because of your single system here, but that makes it a lot easier to adjust, so I understand why you did it. These will go away. We just kind of did it really quickly. Wanted to make sure we had two instead of one because it was really moving back and forth. So made it pretty easy to get the legs in between. And so that's what we did on that. So that just keeps people from moving around. You can see this is where your original one was. Looks like it's almost impossible to get the legs underneath there. And it was. But now you can get them in between. I left it so that we could still adjust while we test it. And then eventually we'll decide whether or not we need to adjust it or just keep it, keep it that way as far as the height of this goes and the thickness of the legs that go in between. I would think that some form of adjustment would be necessary. I'm not sure we need to be able to randomly adjust it or adjust it fast. What does need to be adjusted quickly, I believe, are these front bars. Now, you can see that I've messed with your messed with your bars, and the reason I've done that is, two, really. One, that not everybody has the same height. So we talked about this. We've taken out one of the bolts so that we can make it adjust. And so you can see how it is now, nice and wide. And is it wide enough? That's a good question. We've measured this to be 36 inches apart. And it sounds like I live in a veterinary clinic all of a sudden. Dogs are barking out there. We've made it so that it's this width between here and there is right now about 36 inches apart. And when it comes all the way to the top, you have about 7 inches. Actually, that looks even closer. It looks like we made an adjustment down here, so that made it come even closer. But about 7 inches when everything's put together, which is fine. I mean, that's too close. But it gives you the idea. It may give us an idea of how we can do flutter kick on this. That's something I want to talk to you about too. But we certainly can do whip kick, and we showed you that in a video. But let's go back to the front arms. So not all swimmers are the same width, and we want really people to catch pretty far out here. So we did another thing with your machine is, okay, all we did here to make that rotate is just took out a bolt, and then we can just rotate it and play with it. And I've been on here, and we can pull with it in this position. The only thing that started to happen was, as you can see on this side, is when you pull, you just have to cut a little piece of this away, and that's what I'm going to do. It looks like it's already starting to cut it, and I don't want it to cut this, so we're going to actually cut that apart down just a little bit. We're going to try to make it look good so that it, like you meant to do that, or I meant to do that. The only thing we're thinking about with the width is we might want to make the arms taller so that you can get even wider than this, because although this works pretty well for me at 5'9", I don't think it's going to work as well for somebody at 6'9". So, although you got to admit this is so much better when you catch the water in butterfly and breaststroke, and probably even better for whip kick too. But what we'd like here is for this part here to be easily adjustable up and down, easily adjustable, so it locks in, and then you maybe pull it apart, locks in, pulls apart, whatever. Or maybe a little button down here where we can push it and move it exactly to where we want. It's kind of a mess in here, but I'm going to go over and show you how we did it with the mini gym. And this was pretty slick. It was actually pretty easy. You can just see right there, there's just a pin. You pull it out and you slide it in, and it goes narrower or wider, etc. So that's how we did it with that. It was really very, very easy. But I think yours could be slicker and also maybe even provide some form of measurement for people. But at this point, we can immediately go to here. The problem is I can't probably get it strong enough with these at this moment. I haven't figured it out yet. With this one bolt being gone now, it's a little bit loose. And of course, we could just tighten it down with a bolt too. The other thing we'd do is maybe just drill through and we'd have it wider. But that's not how we want to do this. We want to be able to because what normally happens with swim benches is a team will have one or two. It's great if they had 30 for 30 swimmers, but it's just not going to usually work out that way. You and I wish they did, but it's pretty rare. So you'll get a series of swimmers in here at different heights, and you might get a freestyler coming in right behind a butterflyer. So let's just do that. Freestyler coming in behind a butterflyer. Okay, so we just pull that up. He locks in, he comes in, and he does his work. He also needs to be able to lock, get this thing from locked to unlocked a lot faster. So I'm going to show you really quickly what we did on this bench. So this is the same way. We've got a Vasa sitting on top of it. We try to make sure we can park the car in here when we're all done, so you get the idea. But we'll take all this out and show it to you nice. But you can see how this is a pin. It goes like this, and then that just pulled it out of this hole. So let's put it back in. See that? So now it won't turn, and so we pull it out. It's on a spring. We just turn this. Now it's on the spring, and now this will rotate. Okay, so it's as simple as that, and I think that's how yours ought to be. Okay, I think it's called a spring screw or something. I did find one online, and I think I sent that to you. But you get the idea. It's a little bit awkward right now, but you get the idea. All right, so that's what that's about. So those are just a couple of ideas that are, I think, essential. The front mobility of this will be the first one that does it that well. And again, I think the one thing we might want to consider as a major improvement, not that major really, is just to make these a little bit taller. Nobody's going to use it all the way up here unless they're kicking, which again, being taller would be a good idea. So this will be about freestyle right about here. And you notice that's actually narrower than the way that it was designed. You kind of made a compromise to about here, and it was a good compromise, but really it was a compromise. And that would be a compromise too, to be all the time out wide like that. So, but I don't think you have to get so much that this comes down wider. Oh, there's one more thing we did. Because this was still, even though we took off the cover, this was still a little bit, what you can see on this one. This one was still a little bit narrow here. And it's not too bad. If you cut down the cover, it's really not that bad there. But I took out a screw here and made this come over, and even when it's up, so then this is actually pivoted. See that? So we pivoted that and gave us a little bit better angle. We could probably like a little bit better angle, but this is catching it right here when I do this. You can try it with your own bench. So maybe move this down just a little bit, or this up just a little bit, and then we'd have it out of the way and we could rotate it just a little bit more so it's a little bit smoother, but it's not catching anything or hurting anything now. And I think it's actually pretty good. And then when we rotate this, not a big deal. Of course, that's right in the middle where you basically designed it. But I really don't think that's horrible right there. I don't think it's going to hurt the bungee. I don't think it's going to wear anything out. All right, Gray, we'll talk to you soon. Hopefully you like my brain. It's constantly working on this stuff. And we'll go from great, which is what we started with, to really great and impossible to match. This swim bench in its present configuration, it's the only one in the world that's being made right now that rotates. It now has a good back part of it that keeps people solid, and I think a lot safer than the other one was, with just the feet on top. It will now be the only one that has an adjustable front, because they're not making that anymore at Mini Gym. Obviously, I could have started making it, but I'm excited to meet you, and we can just work together on making the very best swimming machine in the world, and it's really good right now. Let's just keep making it better. Talk to you soon. Bye.